What is a TTRPG?
Wait, is it TTRPG or just TRPG?
Let me start again. What is a TRPG or tabletop role-playing game? In role-playing games have a pretty long and boring history to them. I'd get into it, but I also don't want this video to be like 40 years long. So I'm just going to try and keep it short. This means that I'm also only talking about the genre of tabletop role-playing games, not just on D&D. So, what is a tabletop RPG? In their most basic forms, you get two things. One, a storytelling game, and two, make-believe game. That makes this shit sound so much more fucking lame than it already is, but that's what they are. It's like writing a book. You and your group of friends just tell each other what's going on. There's a bunch of rules to help you figure out what happens. How do you play a tabletop RPG? These type of games, also called pen and paper role-playing games, are played like radio dramas, audiobooks, etc. You don't act out anything like charades or a play. Only the speaking component is acted. It's group storytelling, essentially. One person controls the world. They're known as GM. DM, Master of Ceremonies, depends on the system. They tell everyone what's going on. Everyone else controls the character in that world, announcing what they're doing. You use dice to determine whether your actions succeed or fail. The GM will introduce a goal or goals for the players to do through the actions of their created characters. The GM will then describe a scene. They will narrate what happens, say who's present, where the player characters are, and non-playable characters are. And then they will ask the players what their characters do. The players will then take turns describing what their characters do, sometimes their actions necessitating a rule. And so the cycle repeats. GM describes the scene, players describe their actions, and then a rule. You, as a player, can do whatever the fuck you want. But the GM usually already has a story in mind for everyone to follow, whether it's a pre-made adventure from a book or something of their own creation. Different systems do certain things different, obviously. Some systems may have more rules and might need you to make some more rules to determine an action, etc. Others may be rules light and just let you go off and do whatever the fuck you want. Others involve more math. A certain tabletop RPG involves you pulling a Jenga block out of the Jenga block tower. If the tower falls, your character dies. I'm going to cuck you and not tell you guys the name of this particular system. You can find that shit out yourself. Now, as far as the rules go, the GM, in a lot of cases, has the final say in these things. As the GM, you can tailor your experience for you and your players however you want. You can change a rule if you don't like it, you can introduce your own house rules, you can eliminate a rule, etc. It's up to you. See the rules more as guidelines for you to follow and change them accordingly to how you want the game to be like. Where can I play a tabletop RPG? Anywhere, for the most part. Tabletop kind of gives the impression that you need a table to play on. And yeah, you'd be right. You do, if you have stuff to put on that table. If you have maps or miniatures, terrain, etc., then yeah. However, these type of games can be played with the bare minimum. That means all you really need is just you and your friends, your voices, and your imagination. Personally, I like having physical stuff to show to my friends because I know it's hard to do it all in your head. But my point still stands, you can do all this with the bare minimum. So you can play anywhere really, as long as you bring a set of dice for your group, and as long as the GM has a story that they want to run, or they just improvise one at the spot, which props to you guys. You don't even need to meet up in person. There's websites, phone apps, where you can play RPGs from home, over the computer. The table isn't the essential thing you need. What you really need is just you, your friends, your mind, and nothing else. Well, what should I play? D&D has been having a resurgence over the past few years. this resurgence, starting with streamers and podcasts, running their games, making them more accessible to everyone because of social media and the internet. Even Stranger Things has helped put D&D out there even more. So D&D is a good place to start if you never played these types of games before. It's the most accessible and it's the easiest place to start. You can find the free rules online or go to your local Circuit City or Kmart and pick up a starter set from there. They're only 20 bucks. But what if you don't want to play in a medieval fantasy setting? Well, that's why I like tabletop role-playing games. D&D is the mainstream, sure. It's the most popular one, so it shadows a lot of other great systems. Maybe you want to play in a more modern setting. Get my second favorite, Monster of the Week. Hunt high school beasties, a la Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Travel to country to bring down unnatural creatures like the Winchester Brothers of Supernatural. Or head up the government investigation like Mulder and Scully from X-Files. Maybe you want to play in a galaxy far, far away. Get Star Wars Edge of the Empire and following expansions. Maybe you want to scratch that Stranger Things itch. And you want to play as a group of kids, teens, or adults going through life. Get Kids on Bikes. There's a plethora of books and systems to pick and play from. And I really do wish I could go and talk about every single one of them, especially my favorites. But then this video would be like 40 years long. As long as you have the interest to try one of these games out, that's all you need. You can find any type of system that fits your need with the story that you and your friends want to tell. And then it doesn't even matter because all of these systems are fun. Well, where should I go from here? Now, usually the person who wants to try out tabletop RPGs, usually the one who's watching this right now, they end up being the GM. They're the ones who end up in charge of gathering everyone to play. They're the ones who also end up telling the story and running the game. Sometimes that's not the case. Maybe you're just a player, whatever. The only steps left to take from here is to pick a system, D&D, Pathfinder, Kids on Bikes, Monster of the Week, Star Wars, etc. Learn the rules. Most systems rule books come with a short pre-made adventure you can run right away. Now, if you want to be at the safe side, I suggest finding a game system that has a starter set and that'll get you up and running right away. Grab some snacks and your friends and you're set. Okay, I hope you guys liked this video of me not really explaining RPGs at all and just doing the bare fucking minimum. If anything, you probably just left more confused than before. I probably just put you guys off the idea of tabletop RPGs altogether. But if you did make it this far, then thank you. And I really do hope I introduce some new folks to these type of games. They're a big passion of mine. My friends call me really big fucking nerd because of it, but it's something that I really like and I always try to introduce people to them. Maybe down the road, I'll make an updated video talking more in depth, going, you know, deeper into the rules, what makes RPGs, maybe the history of tabletop RPGs, or maybe I'll talk about a specific system that I like, but that's for another time. Now, this is Diego Messina, resident graphic designer, signing off. Thank you. There's a plethora.